CNN said that Taiwan is one of the top 10 vegetarian places to eat in the entire world. This one is called vegetarian steam dumplings.
You cannot put a steam dumpling all in your mouth at once, or that happens. I told you.
Hi everyone, it's Jason and welcome to Jason's Table Shocked and Surprised, where we take a look at some of Taiwan's most amazing, surprising, and sometimes shocking foods. In today's episode, I'm joined by special guest Tom. Tom, nice to meet you. I'm Jason.
Nice to meet you.
Hello.
Hello.
Russell, nice to meet you. Sonia, nice to meet you. Hello. So Sonia, we are going to be looking at some vegetarian cuisine. Mm-hmm. I think a lot of people don't realize, but CNN said that Taiwan is one of the top 10 vegetarian places to eat in the entire world.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so we're going to play a little game. Mm-hmm. There are going to be some dishes coming out here, and we're going to taste test, and you have to guess which one is a Michelin level cuisine. Mm-hmm. So Michelin, the guide really focuses on elegant, fancy, elevated cuisine. But we're gonna have to take a guess. If you guess them correctly, then you get a prize. If you guess incorrectly, then there's a punishment.
Okay.
So you'll find out what it is. Mm-hmm. Okay. I hope you're hungry, because are you ready for the first dish?
Yes.
Okay, so let's get started. Sonia, we have our first set of dishes. And these are both vegetarian, and they contain the same ingredient, which some people love, some people don't love. It's tofu. Which one do you want to try first?
This one.
This one. Okay.
It's good.
Good?
Yes, I like it. It's kind of meat, really. Mm. If I don't know, mm-hmm. I will think that this is meat.
Mm. But this is nice.It didn't look like tofu, mm-hmm. but when you taste it, it's tofu. Mm-hmm. This tofu is nice though, I like it.
I have the meatball, the fake meatball. It is tofu. It's very soft. It's juicy.
It's very juicy.
Yeah.
But it does have a creamy texture, whereas regular meatballs might have a little bit firmer texture. Mm.I think the flavor is nice.
I like it better than a meatball.
Like it better than a meatball? Mm-hmm. Okay. So you tried that one. Mm-hmm. Pretty good, right?
Yes.
Okay. So are you ready to try this one?
Yes.
Okay. So this one is the stinky tofu. Typically, stinky tofu is sometimes fried, but this one is braised in a sauce. First time stinky tofu.
Little bit spicy and salty.
Mm-hmm.
Very good.
It's very delicious actually. Yeah, it's a little bit spicy and the tofu is not very soft, but it is soft enough to eat.
Stinky is such a bad word. Let's just, why isn't it called super fragrant
call
tofu?
Call it amazing tofu.
Amazing,
just whatever.
Interesting.
It's great, it advertises itself.
Yes.
You don't need a sign for stinky tofu. You can smell it when you come down the street and you know it's there. It's great.
Let's taste test this one.
It's not just the tofu, that's the broth, the soup is in. That's great.
So if you were to guess out of these two dishes, which one is the Michelin Guide recommended dish?
I like both, but I think this one.
There's a special taste for tofu that I think it should be a very good restaurant and a very good chef too. I'm gonna go with the tofu.
I'm gonna say, they both taste great. I think it's just the concept.I think it's the meatball casserole.
Is the Michelin Guide recommended tofu dish the stinky tofu?
Yes!
In fact, this particular dish is the Michelin Bib Gourmand recommended item. This is from Cao Laoban. And oh. this originally was in a night market, and in 2018 received its Michelin Bib Gourmand. It's not a Michelin star, but the Bib Gourmand just indicates it's high quality food that has a story to it. And this one is from Deli Soys, and they're braised cabbage with the vegetarian meatballs and then the tofu skin. All right, so you are 0-1, but we have two other chances to eat something tasty and have another guest.
2-2. I'm
you ready?
I'm coming, okay. I'm coming, yeah.
Next dishes, here we come. So now it's time to try some other foods.
Okay.
Okay, so we have two more dishes, both of them vegetarian. The first one I have in front of me, it is a Korean style fried cauliflower.
Looks like chicken.
Right, it looks like chicken, like fried chicken. This one is using mushrooms, but it's made to look like a traditional dish of pork intestines. So one of these, again, is Michelin guide recommended, and the other one is not, but still delicious. Which one do you want to try first?
This one.
This one, okay. Smells a little like spicy, but kind of...
Wow.
Wow?
It's amazing.
Mm. It's got a lot of heat on it, though. Are you starting to get that? Or what is that? Is that...
It's not that spicy. Maybe I can take spice more than I thought then. And it's you who can't take it.
Korean's real hot. Everything's so flaming red hot. Flaming red hot.
It's better than I expect, though. And there are like some vegetable things.
Fiber, yes, from the cauliflower. Yeah. This one, yes, please help yourself. You can use these.
Okay.
And you see we're using these chopsticks. These are typically serving chopsticks. So if you're eating with a bunch of people, you would use this to serve. At home, you might use your own personal chopsticks to go in the dish. But when you're with company and new guests, you be polite and you use your serving chopsticks. So please go ahead.
Yep.
This one has a very strong aroma.
So-so. Yes. This one is better.
Oh, it's chewy.
Chewy good or too chewy?
Chewy
like,
good. Okay. Not too chewy. And there's a lot of seasoning.
A lot of seasonings, yeah. Mmm. It's a little spicy. Mm. That flavor and that aroma, I'm getting a lot of ginger and a lot of the basil.
I'm gonna be a vegetarian. If it's that good.
Mm. So, if you had to guess which one of these is the Michelin Guide recommended restaurant, is it Korean fried cauliflower or basil mushroom intestine?
As for me, this one is better, but I think Michelin star is this one.
Why?
Because it's more interesting, I don't know.
Okay.
I'm gonna go with this one. I think it's very difficult for the chef to
make the
this
technique.
Dish.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm gonna go for this, the cauliflower, because the way it's put together isn't something you see in Taiwan very often.
Okay.
So it maybe it's got a bit of international, a bit of fusion, yep, which might indicate that it's a bit more
upscale.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So Tom thinks it is the Korean style fried chicken cauliflower. That is the Michelin level cuisine. Is he correct?
No!
What's going on today?
Yes!
You're doing great! Okay. So this one, in fact, is the basil-scented mushrooms, which are made to mimic the intestine. There's a lot of ginger in there and a lot of basil, so it's a very fragrant, strong aroma to that, okay? Mm-hmm. But not your favorite, you preferred this one?
Yes.
Okay, so this one is a Korean style fried cauliflower and it's from a restaurant called Little Tree Food.
Mm-hmm.
So folks, next time if you're taking Sonia out, she would prefer this one, okay? Sonia has made it to our last round with 2 out of 2 correct. So we have two dishes. Now these are very interesting because they're very different. Mm-hmm. Very different. So one of them looks like a
burger,
like a burger, right? And then the other one, there's a surprise inside the steamer. So you can do the honors.
Okay.
Ta da da da!
Wow! Dumplings.
Dumpling. So please help yourself. There you go.
Thank you.
Take a bigger bite, and I think you make better taste it. In the middle.
So.
Okay.
Yes.
Is it the flavor or the texture? Mostly the flavor.
Flavor. Right? Flavor. Yes.
I'm gonna use two vegetarian food.
Dumplings like this, steamed dumplings, are traditionally served with some ginger, shredded ginger on the side, and also a little bit of a dipping sauce.
But be careful, it might be scalding hot in the middle.
Hot.
I told you, hot. You cannot put a steamed dumpling all in your mouth at once. All that happens.
Delicious, but super hot.
Yeah. Sorry.
So we've had dumplings, and I guess it's time
for
something else, a burger.
Yeah.
There's a little bit of barbecue sauce. You can dip some if you want. There's some already inside the hamburger.
I already washed my hands.
Okay, please. I shouldn't say hamburger, because it's not really a hamburger. It's a burger.
It's juicy.
That's really good. The bread is nice. There's a bit of chew to it. If you didn't tell me that this was not meat, I would not know.
Yeah, it smell like that.
I like it.
If you have friends who ate regular hamburgers, do you think they would like this?
I think yes.
Yeah, yes, because it's super tasty.
I've eaten a lot of them. I haven't eaten this one. Like, you see a lot of them, they get really ready.
Yeah.
This actually, I mean, if you gave that to somebody who eats meat, I don't know if they'd know.
They would know. They wouldn't know. If we were to ask you, though, which one is the Michelin starred cuisine? Is it the steamed dumplings or is it the burger?
This one.
And why do you think the dumplings?
Just feeling.
I'm gonna go with the dumplings.
The dumplings, okay.
I'm gonna go with the
dumplings. And why the burger?
It is very good.
I don't have any fault with it.
I will give them a star.
Okay. Russell says this one deserves a Michelin star. Does this restaurant already have a Michelin star? Is he correct? Is it the burger?
No.
No!
This is in fact the Michelin starred restaurant. So this one is called Vegetarian Steamed Dumplings, and this is from a restaurant called Dian Sui Lo. This is one of the signature dishes. Served with some ginger and some dipping sauce, you have an excellent palate. And this one is from Lab 33. It's a bistro style restaurant where they had their vegetarian burger. I mean, this is to me really tasty. So I would definitely order this and try, so. Okay, well, since you got all three correct, I can give you a prize.
Wow!
Wow!
I hope you like fruit.
Yes, I like.
Present for you. Fruits.
I love fruits.
Well, so what's your record for today?
Can we just skip to the end?
We'll see.
Tom, I want to thank you for joining me.
Thank you very much.
And exploring some amazing and surprising vegetarian cuisine of Taiwan. This is Jason. We're at Jason's Table, Shocked and Surprised. We'll see you next time. Bye.